Buckner, and I'm kind of a newbie to this. I came here last month and was kind of too timid to come up, waited a while, and then was too late, but I wanted to come back. So I'm inspired by a lot of people, but one of my greatest inspirations is Maya Angelou. Learned about her in the 7th grade, and really once I learned one thing, I wanted to know everything about her. And I'm also a big quotes person. And there's a quote from I Know Why the Caged Bird Sings that has kind of been resonating with me lately, and that's kind of why I'm up here. So when Maya, after she had been raped by her mother's boyfriend, in her autobiography, she was meeting with a teacher named Mrs. Flowers because she wasn't speaking for a long period of time. And she would work with this teacher, and the teacher would give her poetry, Shakespeare, different things, and Maya grew to fall in love with it, but she still wasn't speaking. And Mrs. Flowers eventually told her, Maya, words mean more than what is set down on paper. It takes the human voice to infuse them with shades of deeper meaning. And so that quote has just kind of stayed with me, and for some reason resonated with me a lot lately. And like I said, I've written a lot. I've written since I was young, but now I finally feel like I had something that I wanted to give a voice to. So the poem that I'm going to share with you guys tonight is called Audio Vision in an Automobile. Have you ever contemplated jumping out of the car while speeding down the freeway? I don't know why I was blind to the signs before that had flashed at me, bail now. Back when bailing would have been much easier, much less risky. But now I'm here, with you, a passenger in your speeding car, and with every vile and oppressive word you hurl at me, the thought of pulling a stunt like the ones in movies becomes more and more realistic. Why, when I hear the words coming out of your mouth, do I see vileness? And why, when I look at you, do I see your potential? Do I see good? My ears don't see, my eyes do. So why, when I look at you with my 20/20 vision, no glasses, no prescription, do I not see clearly? Do I not see who you're choosing to be? This vision's got me asking silly questions like, why do little secrets gotta be dirty? Why a romantic gotta be hopeless? Why does the world have to be so ugly when it could be so beautiful? And why are you a microcosm of that model? Loyalty is blind. But love, order love, self-first love, because that which I cannot do for myself, I cannot do for you, love, is not blind. Love sees. Love realizes that when you want to jump out of a moving car to escape the presence of vileness, you need to consider why you got in the first place, and you need love to help you see your way out.
Yes.
I see how beautiful and great you could be, but how beautiful and great you are not. I guess my 2020 works like bifocals now.